Brothers and sisters, as we await the great festival of Christmas, let us prepare ourselves so that we be shown its true meaning. Let us rejoice in our songs that the good purpose of God is being mightily fulfilled. Let us celebrate the promise that our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, will bring all humanity and all things into the glory of the reign of God. But first, let us pray for the world which God so loves, for those who have not heard the good news of God or who do not believe it, for those who walk in darkness and the shadow of death, and for the church in this place and everywhere, that it may be freed from all evil and fear, and may in pure joy lift up the love of God. Let us now stand in silence.
prayers come before you, O God, as incense, and may your presence surround and fill us, so that in union with all creation, we might sing your praise and your love in our lives.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. In all circumstances, give thanks, for this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench the Spirit. Do not despise prophetic utterances. Test everything. Retain what is good. Refrain from every kind of evil. May the God of peace make you perfectly holy, and may you entirely, spirit, soul, and body, be preserved blameless for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will also accomplish it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The light shines in darkness.
And the darkness has not overcome.
We shall bear.
to your people the peace that passes all understanding, and the will to live your gospel of mercy and justice, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
God, remember us in your love and teach us to pray.
Give the choir a break because they've been standing so long. But please do not run off. Come back for the second part. So we'll begin in just a moment. So, and we invite you to sing in the music that is there for you to sing.
Thank you. Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Zechariah. Sing and rejoice, O daughter Zion, for lo, I will come and dwell in your midst, says the Lord. Many nations shall join themselves to the Lord on that day, and shall be my people, and I will dwell in your midst. And you shall know that the Lord of hosts has sent me to you. The Lord will inherit Judah as his portion in the Holy Land, and will again choose Jerusalem. Be silent, all people, before the Lord, for he has roused himself from his holy dwelling. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christ, the light of all lights, follows John, the lamp that goes before him. The word of God follows the voice in the wilderness. The bridegroom follows the bridegroom's friend, who prepares a worthy people for the Lord by cleansing them by water in preparation for the Spirit.
Thank you. We'll have a 10-minute intermission.
Thank you. Mary set out and went with haste to a Judean town in the hill country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud cry, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy, and blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken to her by the Lord."
Thank you.
Blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of a fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. And the ransomed of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Beautiful is the God's love. God invites us, and we shout with joy, that we may not be last on that day which comes like a thief. Let us not sleep in the darkness. Let us keep watch with the Lord.
Especially the little Christmas bells, and the tinkling of the piano during whatever song was it? Was that it? Still Stop, I forgot. That warmed a German soul. But there's a lovely reception after this, and thanks again to Deacon Chris and the Festival Choir and musicians.
seated for a moment.
I have a little homily I have to give this evening.
It's about being patient, okay? I want to thank the festival choir, all of them who have worked so hard since September to pull this evening off. They really have worked hard, and I think they've done so well. You know, they've gotten used to me after 12 years. At least some of these people who have sung. It's been a great experience to live in this parish and to work in this parish and to direct these people in song. So I really want to thank them from the bottom of my heart. And thanks to all of you, the community of Incarnation, for your faithfulness in coming out this evening and entering into this prayer as we you know, kind of move forward to the Feast of Christmas, but we're still in Advent. I want to especially thank Amelia Camacho, the Director of Music at St. John's in Waynesboro, St. John the Evangelist. I want to thank Amanda Di Donato, who's home from JMU, who's played by. I want to thank Rich Stevenson, who's done a great job on the guitar. Michael Rosamano on bongos. And a new person playing cello this evening, Pavel Dogaliuk, who's new in the parish. So I want to thank them very much for the little orchestra. I think we did okay. And we were in tune. Great. Now, I want to also thank publicly, and they may be here, they may not be, Jenny and John Kowalski, who have worked so hard to put on the reception, and John was so good to come and help me set up things for this evening. I want to really thank them, because they are such an asset to the parish, and they give so much of themselves. So I really want to acknowledge them, especially in light of the reception this evening. So thank you all for being here. So let's enjoy. Very nice to meet you.